West Virginia's football team won 7 games in 1985, continuing the proud tradition Don Nealon and his staff brought to Morgantown in 1980. Along the way, this group of Mountaineers struggled, much like many residents of the Mountain State, in a year of ups and downs. Injuries devastated the team early, and the search for a quarterback seemed never-ending. Against the worst, this club prevailed, a study of the hope and courage that characterized the people of West Virginia. Good times, bad times, victory, defeat. This group of young men experienced a lifetime of emotions in just 11 football games. But like many of their fans, the people who toiled in a land scarred by nature and the ways of a changing world, the Mountaineers prevailed. And they offered hope for a future better than anything before. At the final gun, the end of it all, to a man, they walked away with heads held high.
Hello, I'm Jack Fleming. Our friends at Magnet Bank and Magnet Mortgages are pleased to present the highlights of the 1985 West Virginia University football season. As a proud sponsor of WVU Sports and the Mountaineer Sports Network, Magnet is happy to bring you the highlights for the fourth year. Magnet Bank invites you to sit back and enjoy Heads Held High.
Before the wheels of one of college football's most successful programs ever got to full speed, injuries began taking a toll on the 1985 Mountaineers. Standout running back Pat Randolph was lost, as was tight end Todd Fisher. From the very start, Don Nealon sensed that winds of change would prevail on the 1985 season.
Gazing into the crystal ball, I felt that going into our season that we would be a strong team defensively, and I believe the record bared that out. However, offensively, we had some problems, and due to the injury of Todd Fisher and Pat Randolph and Kevin Kochen early in the season, and then Chuck Jolliffe with an arthritic toe, made it kind of difficult for our offense to gel. But overall, I felt it was a good year.
One ray of hope was found on the offensive line, where the imposing figure of Brian Joswiak overpowered West Virginia opponents from day one. A hulk of a man, yet gentle as a giant, Joswiak anchored a front that opened holes for Mountaineer runners and offered consistent protection for WVU quarterbacks.
In the season opening 52-13 victory over Louisville, which featured the return to college football of Coach Howard Schnellenberger, Joswiak and his teammates gave evidence of their will to succeed.
West Virginia running backs gained 340 yards on the ground in a superb display. A week later, the WVU defense hogged the spotlight and preserved a 20-18 victory over Duke. This team displayed the kind of determination that forges greatness. Although outdistanced in practically every statistical category, the Mountaineers did what they had to do to win.
The Duke game came down to our defense doing a great job on their last play. They were going for a two-point conversion, and Van Richardson and Matt Smith, our two fine inside linebackers, had a blitz called. Both guys did a super job and did a nice job of running the quarterback down.
Super football Saturday night traveled to College Park, Maryland with the Mountaineers for game number 3, and a national television audience witnessed the kinds of mistakes spawned by youthful inexperience. A good Maryland football team, predicted by some observers to contend for a national championship, capitalized on West Virginia mistakes and took a 28-0 win. Down but not out, the Mountaineers returned home for the backyard brawl, the annual confrontation with the Pitt Panthers. 10 points behind as the second half began, West Virginia rode the arm of quarterback Tony Rita and the running of John Hollifield and the rest of a competent backfield. WVU battled back to a tie, 10-10, as more than 62,000 football fans witnessed a battle royal on the gridiron. Balance and offense typified this West Virginia squad, and no game offered more offensive action than the 24-9 victory over Virginia Tech. Rita got his first start at quarterback, and he used it to lead the Mountaineers to a 14-9 halftime advantage. Hollifield had another 100-yard afternoon, and the Mountaineers pulled away in the final 30 minutes for one of their best performances of the season. West Virginia's defense forced six hokey fumbles and kept the Virginia Tech offense sputtering all afternoon.
After a week off, West Virginia squared off against Boston College in an important road contest.
The Mountaineer ground game again prevailed, and the hard-fought 13-6 win was the result, bringing WVU's victory string over BC to 5. On the downside, Rita suffered an injury that would limit his performance for the remainder of the season and placed the burden of a maturing offense back on younger shoulders. The defense pressured Eagle players into three fumbles and gave up only 52 yards rushing. And Mountaineer kicker Charlie Bauman, stepping into the role made famous by Paul Woodside, tacked on field goals of 42 and 36 yards from the soggy turf of Alumni Stadium. Throughout 1985, Bauman and punter Steve Supre continued to provide the outstanding performances that have earned West Virginia's special teams recognition as some of the most consistent in the game.
Charlie was excellent at mid-range and long-range field goals, and Steve could kick the football anywhere we ask him.
Penn State was up next, and Mountaineer faithful looked to University Park with anxious anticipation. West Virginia had beaten the Nittany Lions for the first time in decades a year before, and many were hoping for a repeat performance. But it wasn't to be, as Penn State, eventually the nation's second-best team, capitalized on the mistakes of inexperience at key positions and walked away with a 27-0 victory. Another road contest awaited WVU the following Saturday. The Mountaineers took the field at Charlottesville, Virginia, ready to avenge an upset the Cavaliers had taken the year before. A night game played in steady rain saw Virginia run its way to a 27-7 decision in spite of fine performances by the Mountaineers' defense and special teams.
WVU came home to prepare for three games against foes that have provided stern opposition in recent years.
Rutgers, Temple, and Syracuse would test this football team's mettle, challenging every man on the roster to battle back one more time.
As a coaching staff, we felt we had to change our strategy the last three games of the year. We went more to a running game, asked our offensive line to come off the ball a little bit more than they had in the past. And we went to a play-action passing game rather than a drop-back game. We wanted to spread that pressure around.
Rutgers was held in check by the Mountaineer defense in Game 9, and WVU took a sweet 27-0 victory. With Hollifield injured and out of action, senior Tom Gray came through with a stellar afternoon. Not only did he snare four passes from sophomore quarterback Mike Timko, but Gray also put on a one-man rushing show, carrying 28 times for 147 yards. Mountaineer defenders applied the heat, and Rutgers kept the ball for less than 29 minutes in four quarters. Possibly more than any other game in West Virginia football history, a November 16th date with Temple at Mountaineer Field will be remembered as something special. Proud West Virginians responded to a plea to help the state's flood victims. Thousands of Mountaineer faithful left 30 tons of food for the people struggling to make their lives right again. And their football team ran over Temple, taking a 23-10 victory as a sign of the spirit and the will to win that is West Virginia. Freshman Undra Johnson chalked up 207 yards in a masterful display of running, becoming the first Mountaineer to rush for 200 yards since Kerry Marbury in 1971.
After our Temple ball game, I had the same question. Where's Andre Johnson been, Coach? What have you been doing with this guy? Hey, as coaches, we knew he was good. We knew he was a fine player. And you're going to hear an awful lot of Andre Johnson in the future.
The season finale would be played at Syracuse, New York, where the Carrier Dome has been unkind to West Virginia football teams. No WVU squad had won there until the 85 Mountaineers capped a year-long struggle with a 13-10 come-from-behind win on ESPN. After Bauman booted two first-half field goals, the Orangemen scored 10 third-quarter points and went ahead. Time was running out. Less than 2 minutes were remaining in the season. Mike Timko calmly stepped into the huddle.
When you're younger and you used to lay in bed at night and think about being involved in a situation where it comes down to throwing a winning touchdown pass or making a drive to win a football game, it was kind of unbelievable to find myself in a situation like that.
Timko went to work on a masterful drive. With 35 ticks left and the ball on the 5-yard line, Timko took the snap and, with poise beyond his years, found Grannis Bell in the end zone for the winning score. The game would be West Virginia's bowl as the Mountaineers finished with a 7-3-1 record.
The season-ending drive against Syracuse certainly showed the character of our football team. We had an awful lot of injured football players. We were playing with a quarterback who hadn't played that much. Mike did a super job. Some of our young receivers did a great job. And it's probably the best drive that we had put together the entire season.
Once again, West Virginia had won at least 7 games. 5 Mountaineer teams in a row now claim that accomplishment, placing West Virginia football among the nation's elite in terms of success. Also among the nation's finest is the home of WVU's football tradition. Mountaineer Field opened 6 seasons ago with John Denver on hand to sing Country Roads. Since then, all roads in this part of the country have led to Morgantown, to this incredible facility, 60,000 plus on football Saturdays. Expanded last year, Mountaineer Field now boasts a look similar to the structure it replaced. The thrill of that special pregame entrance is back. But more important is the home field advantage that has developed in recent years. West Virginia was unbeaten before the home crowd in 1985, and it has won 22 of the last 25 games at Mountaineer Field since 1982.
When our opponents come into Mountaineer Field, they know they're in for a tough day. They know there's always going to be 12 men on the field, 11 football players at all times, and then our fans, the greatest in the country.
As usual, there will be holes to fill on this football team, including one very large gap on the offensive line. Ryan Joswiak has completed his eligibility after earning consensus All-America honors. Joswiak anchored the Mountaineers both on the field and off. He will be remembered not only for his superior play on the gridiron, but for his big heart with the not-so-fortunate kids in the community.
The last 5 years here at West Virginia University have been the greatest 5 years of my life. I've had the opportunity to work with a great coaching staff, and the football players that I played with have been my best friends. I've enjoyed a lot of great victories both on and off the field. I've had the opportunity to be an All-American, which is something not many people can say. It's been great. I had an opportunity to meet Bob Hope. Bob Hope is a tremendous person, one of the highlights of my college career. Off the field, I've had a lot of great victories too. The children at the WVU Children's Hospital and the kids with the Special Olympics, they all hold a special place in my heart, and I hope that when I'm gone, I hope somebody takes over for me, because, you know, the kids really need somebody in their lives.
Look ahead, and a bright future is seen for the Golden Blue. The youthful, hustling players that provided so many thrills will return. More experienced, ready to face the excitement of one of the nation's most challenging schedules. Yeah. No matter what happens, Mountaineer fans will be smiling next fall. Their never-give-up football heroes will arrive at camp in great shape and work hard to prepare for another grueling campaign. These Mountaineers will prevail again with their heads held high. The 1985 West Virginia University football highlights are sponsored by Magnet Bank.